In this example, we want to identify each point four different ways using polar coordinates. In polar coordinates, a point is expressed as an ordered pair where the first coordinate is r and the second coordinate is theta. R is the directed distance from the pole, and theta is the directed angle from the positive x-axis. So let's start by listing two ordered pairs for the given point when r is positive or r is greater than 0. So if r is going to be positive, we can just count the number of units from the pole to the point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for both of these points, we'll let r equal 5. And if r is positive, that means theta must be an angle in standard position where the terminal side would pass through this point, meaning the terminal side would have to be here if r is positive. So any angle that has a terminal side here can be used for theta. So if we want theta to be the least positive angle, it would be the angle from here to here, which we can see would be 180 plus 45 degrees, or 225 degrees. If we want to express this in radians, remember pi over 4 radians is equal to 45 degrees. So we could count 1 pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, 3 pi over 4, 4 pi over 4, and 5 pi over 4 radians. Now remember, theta can be any angle that's coterminal with this angle. So if we wanted another positive coterminal angle, we could just add multiples of 2 pi radians to this, and we'd have another valid angle for theta. But if we want theta to be negative, the angle would have to rotate clockwise from here to here, which would be negative 135 degrees, or in radians, again counting by pi over 4 radians, we'd have negative 1 pi over 4 radians, negative 2 pi over 4 radians, and then negative 3 pi over 4 radians. And of course, we could subtract multiples of 2 pi radians for other negative angles that would be correct for theta. Now let's go ahead and list two ordered pairs where r is negative or less than 0. Well, this point is still 5 units from the pole, so we'll let r equal negative 5 this time. And if r is negative or r is less than 0, then the given point lies on the ray pointing in the opposite direction of the terminal side of theta. So if r is negative, then the terminal side of theta must point in the opposite direction, meaning in this direction here. So any angle that has a terminal side in this location would be correct for theta. So if you want theta to be the least positive angle, it would rotate from here to here, which would be 45 degrees, or pi over 4 radians. And if we want theta to be negative, we'd have a clockwise rotation from here to here, which would be negative 315 degrees, or again, counting by pi over 4 radians, we'd have negative 1 pi over 4, negative 2 pi over 4, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, and negative 7 pi over 4 radians. And of course, any other angles that are coterminal to these angles would also be correct for theta. I hope you found this helpful.